like to introduce our first guest, mum of three, Chloe Bridge. Good morning to you, Chloe.
Good morning.
Your son Arlo, is that right? Seven.
Yeah.
Bit of a fussy eater. Tell us about that then.
Yeah, so he eats the typical beige food diet.
So a bit like my plate.
Very much like that, yeah. Plain bread, plain pasta, chips, no fruit and veg, and the only meat that he eats is in the form of chicken nuggets.
When did this all start?
He started restricting his diet around 18 months, so very early on. Before that, he ate everything, was a very happy eater, and then it kind of went downhill after that.
And have you sought help?
Yes, we've seen a dietitian. The GP's aware of his issues.
Any improvements?
No, it's very much a box ticking thing where they just, yeah.
And are you worried?
Slightly. I'm more worried about the social aspect of it. I don't want him to feel left out or feel different. At the moment, I feel like he's getting okay nutrients. It's not as good as it could be, but in the future, I worry if it continues this way.
Okay, let's bring in Felix Economakis, a psychologist. I mentioned this during the break. I'll just say it to you. Attention-seeking behaviour? Something of controlling behaviour?
Look, let's make a distinction between fussy eating and selective eating, or ARFID, because they're two complete different things. You know, it's a misnomer. So anorexia and obesity are both eating disorders, but they're completely different.
Yes.
So fussy eating is when, you know, you could eat something, but you just want your favourite food or unblemished chicken or whatever the case may be, but with a bit of a bribe, okay, I'll eat it. Selective eating, or ARFID, is an aversion. It's like a phobic reaction to
right.
it. So even if you're bribed with a car or a holiday, which I've heard, or an iPad, you still can't eat it. And you hate this attention. It's the last kind of attention you want. So it's, you know, people can have a phobia about anything. Oh, you know, a dog barked at me. Oh, yeah, fear of dogs. Oh, I choked on something. I'm afraid of food. You're afraid of food?
But where does a phobia of food come from? It's nourishment.
The brain doesn't care. The brain can be spooked by anything, you know, whether it's food or not. So it can be various things. It can be a choking incident. I had a boy live off milk and mashed banana because he choked the first time he had a solid, 18 years old. Yeah. So it can be, I've had living off bread, just bread about three times. Bread and chips, quite common. So it can be from taste buds developing. The 18 months old is a time...
Not touching on the plate. What's that about?
Well, it's safety rules. People think, you know what, I don't really trust food. It's got to behave. It's got to be this way. Or somehow I don't trust. It's got to be done in a certain ritualistic, safe way where I can control it. You know, so people say I can eat fish fingers, I can eat peas, but if they touch, I can't eat them. Well, the stomach doesn't care, but the brain is saying, I've got to eat it this way. And my kids were the same. They were like, first we eat fish fingers, then peas, then broccoli. That's the way it was introduced to them. That don't mess with the system in case you incur some kind of risk. So very risk aversive shows basically you don't trust food.
Okay. And you were telling me during the break, I don't need too much detail, but hopefully you can talk to some of our viewers, but you reckon in some cases you can sort people out in one session?
Most of the time it's one session, yeah. You can go on Facebook and check it out, live feeds, I do live demos. You know, I put my money where my mouth is.
So Chloe's older. Felix,
we'll be there.
And Chloe. While you're meeting each other, still we can have a call.
We've got Lisa from Suffolk on the line.
Mm. Morning, Lisa.
Morning.
What do you know about fussy eating?
Oh, well, I have a 6-year-old, Stan, who only eats Marmite sandwiches for lunch and dinner. And it's been that way for as long as I can remember. And it just causes, like, so much effect on the family, going on holidays, eating out, like your lady in the studio, socially.
Lisa, let me introduce you to Felix. Felix, what can you tell Lisa that might help?
Well, the first thing is it's really difficult with young children because the techniques are there. They've just got to be old enough. They've got to be open and they've got to be mature enough to concentrate, listen enough, not perfectly. And that's the big problem with young children, especially boys. So I would say, and if you email me, I'll send you tips about it. The best thing is stop fighting, you know, wait till your child is ready and open for it. Because as the lady, Sir Laurie said, you know, take down the tension, the fighting, because it doesn't help anyone. The best thing is when he or she is ready, we'll seek help. And it could be 7, 8, 9 years old. About 8, 9 years old is when they can start listening better.
Is there as a nutritionist, I mean, if you'll forgive me, but waiting until 9 years old eating nothing but Marmite sandwiches would worry me somewhat on the nutrition.
But I agree, because I think also some of the times that when the parents come, the parents are so freaked out, my child won't grow properly. And I say, okay, well, let's talk, we'll do a vitamin, there'll be a way that actually they won't be damaged by this. But you're absolutely right, because one of the ways that I talk to children is I get them, I talk to them on their own, and I talk to them about, do you want to go out with your friends for a pizza? Well, then we need to work out how you're going to manage that pizza, because they don't want to be in prison. They are fearful, and you need to offer them tools to get themselves out of the little box they put themselves in.
Okay. Lisa, I don't think we've tried this before in our current phone system. I'm hoping we're going to be able to pass you back to a researcher to get your email so we can pass it on to Felix. I've been told that's going to happen. So, Felix, you'll be talking to Lisa afterwards. Thank you. Let's have another call.
We've got Chrissy calling from Essex.
Good morning, Chrissy.
Hi, morning.
Morning. Fussy eating, your thoughts, please?
Yeah, my son's 12. I was always told that he would grow out of it. He hasn't. It's got worse. He just eats plain pasta, rice, potato. He's never had a pizza, a burger, anything with sauce. And now it's got to the point he doesn't like going out for food, and he doesn't want his friends to know.
Ah, right. So it's starting to impact on his social life. Felix?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, on top of the eating issues, we have a social anxiety issue because people are conscious. Everyone's looking at me, asking me, why won't you do it? Just try it. What's your problem? So people start avoiding it. So now you have two problems. So we come back to, you know, the help is there. If your son is fed up and also wanting to change, then the therapy's out there now, you know, well-proven techniques. So there's no need to suffer in silence, I would say. Yeah.
It's just astonished that you can get to 12 years old in 21st century Britain and have not eaten a burger. And there's an inner part of me which actually thinks, lucky Chrissy, she's not having to deal with that with my friends.
Are any of these issues around weight gain, do you find that too? Are people worried about eating too much or not enough, and are they worried about their
food? No, it's really the food. I mean, people often, I've had professional chefs as my patients. You know, people who love food, they just can't taste their own food, but they're foodies.
What?
So these are people who, and they're the same people, I have to do it by touch and smell and get someone else to taste it. So obviously, you know, this is...
Can I ask as well, very, very briefly, only a few seconds, are boys more prone to this than girls? Because all our callers so far have been...
No, I've had a lot of both. This is completely across the board. I wouldn't say, you know, girls are more, boys are more. Lots from both. It can happen to anyone. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I guess we're going to have to... That burrito, that plate stinks. I mean, it really puts you off fried food, pasta and chips. Anyway, I'm afraid we have to draw a close to proceedings there. Huge thank you to Chloe and to Felix for both giving up their time. And if you two could have a chat, I'd really appreciate it. Likewise, an honour to spend my morning with you two, so it really is. Good luck.